Hey guys, how you doing? So welcome to this week's One Image My Edit. And this week I'm going to be showing you some of the new updates from Adobe Lightroom 2021, which come out this October. So if you haven't already updated your Lightroom and Photoshop, then go and do that now. And you will see all of these new tools that are here. So I say new tools, they are tools that have already you know, been around, but they've changed the layout and they've added in a few extra features. Now this is looking a lot like Photoshop. We are working with layers a lot more, and it can seem quite confusing when you first come to this. It will take you 5 or 10 minutes just to get your head around how it all works, but I'm going to walk you through some of the steps that I've been doing just to familiarize yourself with it. So if you come up to the tools at the top here, you'll see you've got this little circle here, and that's what we're going to be looking at. So when you click on that, you've got all of these selections here. So you've got select subject, select sky, these are new. You've got the brush, lineal gradient, and then radial, and these are old. These used to be in the previous Lightroom, so they were at the top here. Okay, you could just select which one, and then you've got color range, luminance range. So these aren't new. Again, they were in the previous Lightroom, but they've just bundled them all together up here just to make it a lot easier to work with. So one of the things that we can do is we can make selections really quick. So if I want to adjust the sky and the foreground separate, I can do that. So I'll just click on select sky, and Lightroom will do its thing, and it's used AI to select the sky, and it's done a really good job. You can see all around the sides here, it's managed to make that sky selection perfectly all around the trees. You know, to get that well is so good. So now we've done that, if you come down to the bottom here, you can see this color, and you can actually change the color of the mask and the opacity of it as well, which is brilliant because it will help you see two different masks when you're messing around. So now I want to make the adjustment, so I just click on the show overlay, click on that, and I can just make the adjustment. So I might just bring the exposure down a little bit, and just pull the shadows down and the highlights down a little bit, just to make the sky a little bit darker. Okay, so now what we can do is we can make a copy of this. So we can almost like click on select sky again. So we've just done the same thing, but now if you look where it says sky one, mask two here, if we click on these three dots, we can then just click invert, and we've now got a perfect selection of our foreground. So in previous Lightroom, you'd have to brush that in and use other tools, you know, mainly bring that into Photoshop to get this. And it's, again, it's done a really good job here. Really good job. So we can now take this mask off, and now I can adjust just the foreground. So I could come to the shadows here, just pull them up a little bit, and maybe pull the whites up and pull the blacks up a smidge, bit of texture. Okay, but you get the idea. So it's just showing you what it can do on here. So we've got the, you know, the foreground, and then we've got the sky. So a couple of clicks and it's done. It's such a brilliant feature. So the other things that you can do on this, if we come up to here, so create mask, we can do a normal brush selection like we did in the past. So just a brush, and we can select whatever we want. So let's just select, I don't know, down here. Okay, so we can do our selection. So let's just paint this in. Okay, I'm just going to purposely go around like that. And then what we can do is, if we click on the mask, it then comes down to this sort of subdomain sort of mask brush here. So we can add or subtract. So if I want to subtract from this mask, I can click on that and then say, okay, well, what tool do I want to use? I want to use the brush tool. So now we're just going to minus. So I can then just minus in whatever I want. Now, the other way that you can do that is if we come back up to the mask here, so if I come to the brush one, which was the plus tool, you can hold the option or alt key and that will give you the minus, okay? But doing it this way just means you've got a lot more control. You can just really come in, take your time, and just get a really, really, really good selection. Okay, so let me just get rid of that mask. So let's say then we want to change just the fog that's coming in over here. Well, we can do that. So let's create a new mask, but let's select a color range. So our color range, what we now need to do is we can see we've got this dopper. So we can just click once and it will sample an area. Okay, and that's done an amazing job. The other thing that you can do is actually click and drag. So you can see we've missed a couple of bits here in this section over here, you can see. So if I click and drag, this square will come up and that will actually then start selecting a larger area. So you can see there, that's a much, much bigger area now. So we've got more of the fog in there. So with regards to that, what we can then do is come over to here where we can refine this. So we can move the slider towards the plus to increase that, or we can bring it down to decrease that. And again, we can come over here and just keep selecting until we're happy with what we've got. There we go. So if I want to get rid of the other parts, so some of the trees here that aren't in that select, that I don't want in that selection, then I just click on the mask, I come to subtract, and I use the brush. Now I can use any of these. So I'm going to use the brush tool. So that is to take away from this mask. So if I come in a little bit closer, you can see these are the areas that I don't want in because there is no fog in that area. I just want that fog on the right hand side there. So I can push my feather flow and density up. You can see there it's quite high. So let's just paint this in. Okay, it gives you an idea just of what's going on. Now some of this won't go because it's actually to do with the fact that we've created this mask and it's within a color range. Okay, so let's make the adjustment. So click on the show overlay, take that away, and let's just warm that up. So you can see there I'm just warming up that area. Okay, so if you want to get another selection, another way of doing that would be to create a new mask, and then let's do it in the luminance range. So the luminance is just the brightness of something. So in this case, when we look at that adjustment, that color that we selected over here, that fog, was actually the same color that was hitting these trees, and that's because that's the sunlight, that's the sunlight color. So it's picking it up. So another way then would be to just sample the luminance range, and the luminance is just the brightness. And again, we can click singular, so we can select certain areas. Okay, the other thing that we can do again is click and drag, and that is going to give us a selection there. So that's another way of doing it. And what we can do is come up over here, and you can see that we've got the chart here. So we've got the whites here and we've got the blacks this end, and this is our sort of, this is our range. So we can click in the middle and move that up or down. It's entirely up to you. You can then come to this edge here, and this is kind of like, I suppose it's the fall off really of that shade. So we can move them and get a real precise area of what we want. So we can really hone in just on a particular area, and you can see what that enables you to do. So instead of me selecting the fog, I might want to do the trees here. Okay, so I'm going to select the tree areas. So I just want them areas there. And again, you can see how much of that I want in. So now I'm not actually selecting the fog because I've brought these whites down. So I'm now able to adjust just that area. And if I want to get rid of this part because I don't want this bit to be edited, and you can see that the water is not selected. So let's subtract, use a brush tool, and then let's just subtract these areas here. So I'm doing this very freehand and very quick. So I'm just using a mouse, no pen. So now we've done that, we can click on the show selected mask overlay, or the show overlay as it's now known. And you can see the difference that we've got now. So we can just adjust that area that we selected, so we could bring the shadows up properly. And there we go. That's now giving us a really, really good edit. And we can look at these masks just by hovering over them. So we just hover over them. You can then see the different masks, and you can also click on the eye there. So if we click on the show overlay, we can click on the eye, and that will get rid of the mask for us, just to show us what we have done on that particular mask. So you can see there's the fog, and here is the trees again, and here are that's the sky. Okay, so it's really, really straightforward, really. But like I say, you've got this subdomain here, so that's the mask, and then this is almost the edit. So you can invert and you can duplicate as well. You can hide, you can delete it, you can rename it as well. So it's much easier just to call it, say, sky. This one here, so let's have a look at this one. This one would be our foreground, so we can just come in and rename that to foreground if we want to. There we go. So we can just start to see. So this is, again, it's looking a lot like Photoshop. The areas within there are really, really, you know, you can really fine tune and make a local adjustment. So it's really nice. And if you want to see all the masks on and off, so the before and after, so there it is. There's the turn mask on and off. And you can see how good that is. It's a really, really brilliant, brilliant update. So that's most of the features that are being brought in. So this luminance range, color range, these lineal, these aren't new. The select subject and select sky, they're new. But like I said, you can use any of these tools to make a new mask. So we could create a lineal and just click and drag. We can just pull that down. And then from there, we can subtract, and we can say, let's subtract it using the brush tool, and then we can just come in and do that. Okay, so it's really, really cool. It's a brilliant, brilliant update. If you want to start again, then you can just come down to here, delete all masks, and they'll go, or you can hover over them individually and just press delete, and they will be deleted, simply as that. So really, really easy to do, and such a brilliant update. So I hope you've enjoyed that, and I hope that's given you a little bit of clarity on some of the new tools that are available to you. Like I said, it takes a little bit just to get back into the swing of things, because it's a little bit different to how we've worked in the past, but the method is pretty much the same. And if anything, this is going to give you real good knowledge on masks, layer masks and things like that, because that's what it's all about. So, but for me, being able to select the sky, make an adjustment with one click, and then do the same again, and then just invert it, is such a brilliant, brilliant feature, because it just saves so much time, and it gets a perfect, perfect selection on there. So just them two little clicks there, it's just enabled us to do such a great deal of work. So I hope you enjoyed that, and I will see you all in the next video.